Long years ago, we made a tryst with destiny, and now the time comes when we shall redeem our pledge, not wholly or in full measure, but very substantially.
The unemployment rate in India is growing and getting worse every day. If we stay in denial, we only don't take corrective action early enough.
Okhla, the buzzing industrial hub of Delhi, also has in its midst the Deepalaya Learning Center. During one of our community visits, we came across a group of women doing odd jobs there. They came from disadvantaged backgrounds, having to drop out of school to assist in the housework due to financial problems and social pressure.
They told us about themselves and their problems. During the course of interaction, we discovered that most of these women were quite adept at sketching and painting and were looking for opportunities to enhance their income without having to travel several kilometers away from their homes to factories to do laborious work.
As per a recent study, the share of women in the workforce has fallen to a historic low of 23.3% in 2017-18 against a global average of 48%.
Studies by UN and ILO suggest that if more women are inducted into the workforce, India's GDP could jump up by 4.2%.
So what could we do to help these women?
Our research and development team came across studies which showed that 40% of Indians change their mobile phones every 12 months and 75% of smartphone users have a cover on their phones, thus concluding that there exists a huge market for sale of mobile covers.
That's how we came up with Project Noha. Noha is a biblical term that means guide. This gave us the whole structure and underlying ethics for this project.
Our first step was collecting phone covers in bulk. Old cover collection drives were conducted in and around our college. A few of these covers were used in the making of the first batch of prototypes, which were designed and sold by our team.
But how will faded old covers compete with brand new ones?
The base of old discolored and transparent covers were painted end to end and then they were designed. To make them more durable and attractive, they were thinly coated with varnish and then hairspray was used to give them a fine finish.
For ensuring the scalability of the product, a market research was done by a team to determine the most common mobile phone models, so as to start with designing and sale of those handcrafted covers which had highest market demand and then moving on to other models as more orders came in.
Bulk suppliers were contacted and we tied up with one such supplier who provided us with good quality covers at the rate of Rs. 20 per cover.
After finalizing the prototypes, along with a few designs, we met the women of Okhla to tell them about our project. 18 women showed a great interest in joining our project as a means to enhance their income.
We then held workshops where these ladies were first taught how to draw the designs on waste plastic files and then moved on to making the same designs onto the phone covers.
After they perfected the designs that we had finalized, the women were then encouraged to come up with their own ideas so as to provide them a platform where they could use their creativity while adding a personal touch to the phone covers.
The covers were designed with simple art tools such as pens, paints, and brushes, considering all the input costs, including marketing, transportation, and profits. The products were priced ranging between Rs. 150 to 250, depending on the complexity of the design and finish.
Here, the question arises that how our product will stand out if the price range is at par with those already available in the market?
Well, we have adopted a niche marketing strategy of adding a personalized thank you note from the woman who made the cover into the envelope. This helped educate customers about who made the cover they just bought and gave us an edge in the selling process.
We decided to test the waters with our handmade covers and personalized thank you notes by launching our project during our own college fest in March 2019.
That was the first stall put up by us and the response we got was overwhelming. We sold 24 covers in 2 days, and thank you notes not only gave us an edge, but also helped us convey the stories of the women who made them.
We then put up stalls in colleges like MDI, art fairs, and even in the Enactus Nationals competition last year. Slowly, we took to selling our product online through Instagram, Facebook groups, as well as Telegram channels.
When the sales started picking up, an option of getting the cover customized as per the customer's needs was also included.
We have also collaborated with a few vendors in Connaught Place who bought a total of 200 covers from us for Rs. 150 to 200.
By the end of 2019, we had sold a total of 342 covers.
At this juncture, an apt question would be that if you could sell 342 covers within 9 months of launching the project, then what must have been the time taken to make one cover? And how much did the person making it earn?
After a couple of workshops, the ladies were able to design quite impressive phone covers.
Next, in every visit, we were handed 7 to 10 ready-to-sell covers by them. It took 1 to 2 days to complete one product and the women were paid Rs. 50 per visit. Other than that, all the profits were distributed to them as the steady income promised by us.
The first competition held by us was Call It Art as a part of NOSIS 2019, the annual fest of an actress ADGITN. The competition aimed to explore the creative skills of the participants while promoting the project and the cause. 41 people participated in it and it gave us new design ideas for our future productions.
We also started a campaign called Humans of Noha on our Instagram page where we tried to talk about the hardships these women face throughout their lives.
The second and most recent competition hosted by us during the lockdown was called Doodle Down. This competition required the participants to doodle about how they feel amid this quarantine period. The competition caught the attention of 53 doodle artists all over the world who helped us promote our project and the cause behind it.
We currently have a campaign running on the history of Project Noha, which takes the consumer on a journey that we went through during the initial phase of the project.
And now, after being a part of a process that required them to use their artistic abilities while earning a stable income doing what they love, the women state that Project Noha has provided them a platform where they feel confident and empowered.
As of now, we are at a total of 516 covers sold with a profit percentage of 85.6% with the help of very talented and hardworking women working with us to produce beautifully handcrafted mobile phone covers.
If we are procuring the raw materials and are selling the product, then how will this project be scalable for these women in the long run?
Well, tie-ups with local shops that can provide them with raw materials like transparent phone covers and materials needed for designing those covers.
Collaboration with shops and vendors like Ingafar Market and Connaught Place who are willing to buy the finished product directly from the woman will ensure a constant source of income for them and so will online sales.
During the pandemic, we decided to take our project online and are currently in talks of collaborating with Amazon and Flipkart, thus helping us cater to a wider audience of different age groups.
This will ensure scalability.
The skills involved in product making, like sketching, painting, etc., are easy to learn, so various communities and women can be a part of the project and help the project sustain.
Collaborations with new communities like the Ren Basera community near Jama Masjid, who are now also actively involved in the project.
That is sustainability.
Project Noha is a medium for working towards fulfillment of the following sustainable development goals, one step at a time.
Fifth sustainable development goal, gender equality.
Eighth sustainable development goal, decent work and economic growth.
10th Sustainable Development Goal, Reduced Inequalities.
12th Sustainable Development Goal, Responsible Consumption and Production.
Since the lockdown started, we have been planning to expand the project further and have decided to foray into designing pop sockets. Statistics show that the pop socket market is a booming market and it grows by 800% every year.
Other common mobile and laptop accessories are laptop and phone skins and laptop stickers, which can also be designed by the ladies on order.
Project Noha is born out of our passion for social and economic upliftment of our women folk. Through this, we want to empower women and create jobs.
We hope that the success of Project Noha will inspire women for years to come, thereby supporting sustainable and inclusive growth.
Coming to one of our recent projects, Project Abir, through which we have ventured into the soaps and dry shampoo market, aiming to make cheap and affordable organic alternatives at the same time providing employment opportunities to a community in Saket.
Despite being a popular option in the market, chemical soaps are toxic both in terms of chemical that cause harm to the aquatic life and the use of plastic packaging.
We are using waterproof paper mache packaging, and that makes our product environment friendly as well as organic.
The production of these bars involves readily available raw materials like essential oils, lye crystals, coconut husk, etc. The best part about the production is that it is an easy process in which no water is wasted and can be inculcated within various communities, increasing employment.
Now that we got our products tested, we plan to target immediate audience like peers and family. We also plan to reach out to nearby stores for sale. The maximum use of miniature toiletries is mainly in the hotel industry.
So we aim to target companies like Oyo, Fab Hotels or GoIBibo with a wide network of hotel chains.
Enactus ADGITM is committed towards social development of underprivileged sections of society and furthering their self-confidence by sustainable projects which enable them to earn their own money. Thank you.